This enclosure is used as a transition point between your outside plant portion of a network and your inside plant portion. We'll be using the Corning's Fast-Track MTP Connector to make this transition, which uses patching method instead of a traditional fusion splicing. To access the inside of the enclosure, there's a latch mechanism that can open with or without a key lock. Inside the enclosure, there's a label card that you can document your patching layout according to your customer or industry standards. There's also a hook at the top of the door that will allow you to hold your top cover of the RCE enclosure. To remove the top plate of the enclosure, simply push out on either side of the swell latches on the top of the plate and remove. This gives us full access to the cable entry foam and the retention brackets. To remove the door, hold onto the top and bottom, lift up off of the hinge pins, and set it aside. On the inside of the enclosure, you'll find the patch tray housing. It can accommodate up to 24 patch trays and is easily removable for cable installation. To remove the patch tray housing, pull in on the plungers on either side of the housing and tilt down until it is caught by the safety lanyards on either side. Keeping one hand on the housing, lift up and out on the safety lanyards and rotate down. To remove the housing, keep one hand on the enclosure, lift up and out to remove, and then set it aside. The enclosure is designed to let you install four outside plant cable assemblies in the four center positions and up to 12 inside plant cable assemblies on both the left and the right hand side. Using two of the cable ties provided with the enclosure, start your installation by attaching the cable to the retention clip. There are two slots built into the retention clip for the cable ties to pass through, and the triangular shaped features on the back of the clips that will slide easily into the cable retention brackets. After attaching the retention clip to the cable, tear the cable entry foam down the row where the cable will be installed and remove the round cutout to create an opening for the cable. To secure the cable, align the triangular feature on the retention clip with the slot in the cable retention bracket. Push the cable against the bracket and slide the cable down until you hear a click, or see that the cable retention clip is sitting completely flat on the retention bracket. Repeat this process for any additional cables being installed in the enclosure. When installing your cables, start in the far back position on the cable retention brackets, fill the entire back row, and then work your way forward. If the cable needs to be repositioned, push the top of the retention clip towards the cable, lift up, and pull out on the cable to detach it from the retention bracket. To reinstall the tray housing, place the plungers back into the receivers on either side of the enclosure. While keeping one hand on top of the tray housing, reattach the safety lanyard on each side then tilt the top of the tray housing back inside the enclosure. You may have to pull in on the plungers to fully seat the housing in place. With your cables installed, you're now ready to route your pre-connectorized cable assemblies into the patching trays. To access the patch tray, lift up on the retention bar, push down on the clip at the top of the patch tray until it releases, rotate it down towards you. Lift up and out on the patch tray, and remove the cover before setting it aside. When ready to route inside the tray, Corning recommends you use the optional tray service platform. This will hold your tray at the right angle as you work. The tray rests with the clip facing down and the cable entry points resting on the top of the tray. To prepare the outside plant cable subunit for installation into the patching tray, attach the subunit retention clip onto the subunit. The subunit retention clip is a clamshell design that fits around the exposed ribbons on the cable subunit. Orient the retention clip so that the round tubing feature extends backward towards the subunit jacketing. To secure the retention clip in place, slide the clip towards the braided mesh tubing on the ribbons and slide the mesh tubing over the round tube feature. Place electrical tape around the mesh tubing and the tube of the retention clip to secure the clip. Be sure the tape overlaps both the mesh and the tubing of the retention clip to prevent the cable from sliding. From here, you can secure the cable subunit retention clip to the patching tray by aligning the triangular feature on the bottom with the keyhole feature on the patching tray. Push the clip into the keyhole and push up until you hear a click or see that the clip has secured in place. Using the engraved raceway as a guide, route the ribbons from the subunit into the tray. Now you can start installing the Fast-Track MTP connectors into the adapters in the tray. First, remove the dust cap from the connector housing that has been pre-installed into the adapter. Then guide the connector into the housing until you hear a click. The Fast-Track MTP connector has a keying feature that the connector will only be mated to the connector housing in one orientation. If the Fast-Track MTP connector is not fully seated in the connector housing, slide the connector back out of the connector housing and reorient the connector. Each of the adapters has a number etched into the base of the patching tray for ease of identification. Additionally, each of the Fast-Track MTP connectors has a number labeled at the base of the connector. Install the connectors into the adapters in accordance with your specific system design. To install the inside plant cable assemblies into the patching tray, slide the pre-connectorized legs of the inside plant assemblies into the fingers at the entrance of the tray. Match each of the MTP connectors from the inside plant cable assembly to the Fast-Track MTP connectors of the outside plant assembly according to your specific system designs. With all the connectors mated and installed, slide the cover back on top of the tray. To put the tray into the housing, face the U-shaped feature towards the rear of the housing. Slide the tray up and back until the U-shaped feature rests on the retention bar. Rotate the tray back until you hear the clip on the top click into place, and then lower the tray retention bar. If you remove the door, you can reinstall it by lifting up the hinges and putting them on the pins, sliding that down, then close the door and secure the latch to finish your installation. Thank you.